Today, once again, I'm coming to you from Country Classic Cars here in Staunton, Illinois. And I thought today was a good day to continue our shed tours here. And this particular shed is pretty huge. As you can see, it goes back there a good distance for sure. And actually, I just finished up doing a video in the smallest showroom that they have on the other side of the door there. But I thought I'd go ahead and continue on into the back area here. I will tell you right up front, we're right on the interstate, and with the doors open, it can get pretty noisy from time to time. So hopefully you'll be able to hear me here. But right here at the front door is a 1953 Mercury two-door, and definitely a sharp looking car. Nice chrome bumper there. It's got those big, you know, almost like the Dagmars that they had on the Cadillacs at the time. Nice airplane inspired hood ornament up top there, which is also sort of a faux hood scoop. It's got painted steel wheels with full caps. Just really nice little bits of trim on these Mercuries. Pretty impressive. This thing's really sharp on the inside as well. And for the most part, it's been left untouched, other than at some point over the years, they put some seat covers on these seats. Still has the full factory wheel with a horn hoop and everything, and really impressive looking dashboard. I like these airplane style toggle switches. Definitely has a cool look to it. This one is powered by the flathead V8 as well. I actually have a full video of this on our channel if you want to look up 1953 Mercury Custom. Then right next to that, we actually have a 1967 Pontiac Grand Prix. Pretty unique styling on these. It's riding on an old school set of Krager mags with white letter tires. It has a two-door hard top, so there's no B-pillar getting in the way there. So the windows all, you know, roll down nice and open. All black vinyl interior. It's got the kind of mid-height bucket seats there. It's an automatic on the console. Pretty sharp looking car. I mean, it's a massive car for a two-door though. Pretty huge. Then next to that, we actually have a 1957 Ford Fairlane 500. It's got those shrouded headlamps there, but on these they kind of jut out a little bit. Painted steel wheels with caps. And of course in 57 you had a pretty good set of fins out back, just like you did with the Chevys. Got your Fairlane 500 badge there, and these look pretty good in two-tone. I like it. This one's been pretty much left alone. It's all original. No restoration work in there. It does have the add-on air conditioning underneath the dashboard there. Fender-mounted mirrors. Then next to that, we actually have a 1974 Olds Delta 88. It's got the quad headlamps. Pretty nice looking grill there. And those are just wire caps, not true wire wheels. Obviously this one is a convertible, and they have replaced the top. Nice big comfortable car. See, it's got the flip down armrest there in the center. But I mean, that'd be a nice cruiser. Then we got a Nova sedan right in front of that. We'll get to that in just a second here. But right here, we actually have a 1951 Buick Super. One of the porthole Buicks. And just a ton of chrome up front on this one. It's got this cool kind of gun sight hood ornament. I like that. has period correct color on that one. It's got the big Buick caps on there. Those are some pretty cool hubcaps. I mean, they look like baby moons on there, basically. You got your portholes, of course. Pretty smooth looking car, though. And a ton of room in these things. Here, we'll look in the back. I mean, if you can check out the leg room in there. Pretty massive car. I'll take a peek at the dashboard. It's got the big steering wheel with a full horn hoop. And this one is an automatic. And, pretty impressive looking dashboard there. Seats are in really nice shape. Those have been fully reupholstered and everything. Behind that, we have a little Ford Ranchero. I believe it's a 62 model. See, it's got the little faux hood scoop. Nice chrome grille. That'd be a fun one. I don't know what it has in it. I think it's a six-cylinder. But that'd be a fun little thing to put a 289 in. Of course, you got your little truck bed out back here. I mean, it looks to be in pretty solid shape. Looks pretty original inside. I apologize if that noise bothers you, but I really can't do a lot about it. Nice Ford F100 pickup, looks like. It's been customized quite a bit, though. You can see it's all custom grille and everything. A little unusual. Then in front of that, we actually have a 1972 Olds Cutlass Supreme. That's a pretty sharp looking car. Got the quad headlamps, nice chrome bumper, and, got the little trim pieces up here on the hood. Pretty sharp car. It's got the Olds Raleigh wheels on there, some BF Goodrich tires. And these are hard tops as well, so again, no B-pillar there. It all rolls down and it's nice and open. Looks to be in pretty good shape. Big split back bench seat with headrest. Pretty much untouched in there. In front of that, we have that Nova sedan. It's riding on some nice Raleigh wheels. And it says it's a 73 with 56,000 original miles. We're going to get a little wind noise here, but I'm going to back up just so you can get a good look at it, hopefully. That's a pretty sharp looking car. In front of that, we actually have a 1968 Austin Healey. Cool little British sports car. And it's pretty dirty at the moment, but it looks like it's in that dark British racing green. Got the Austin Healey Sprite badge there. It says 53,000 miles on that one. Well, it's a tiny little thing, that's for sure. Behind that, we have a 1966 Chevrolet Impala. And actually, my son Jordan loves this car. He comes up here once every couple weeks and looks at it. He just has a thing for these Impalas for some reason. Got the quad headlamps there. This one has a 283 in it. It does have a nice set of Raleigh wheels with some BF Goodrich tires. All the Super Sport badging and everything. Nice chrome mirror there. It's got the Chevy bow tie on there. It's an aftermarket piece. Overall, it's a nice solid car. It's got some cheap seat covers covering those, but the rear seat's in pretty good shape. I don't know about the front ones. It is an automatic on the console. And it's got that gauge pack there in front of the console. It kind of reminds you of the gauge they had on the Camaros in the late 60s. Not quite the same thing, but the similar idea. The reason Jordan likes them is because they have this fastback styling, you know, with that very flat rear glass. Yeah, that can look pretty cool. I'm not a real fan of the yellow on a car that big. Personally, I think it'd look pretty mean and like black. But still a pretty cool car. Let's see here. Back behind that, we have a 1962 Buick. And believe me, you don't see these very often. I think I've only videoed a couple of them. Pretty cool looking car. Quad headlamps. I like how the front of the fender comes to a point there. Sort of juts out. Your special badge there. This is a convertible. And they put a newer top on it. Pretty original on the inside, looks like. And a lot of these, I'm not exactly sure what's under the hood of this one, but a lot of those, I believe, came with that little 215 Buick V8 that made its way into tons of other vehicles, especially over in the UK. Basically, they based the Rover V8s on that, so it found its way into tons and tons of cars over there. That's pretty cool. And up here we have a 1969 Chevrolet Impala convertible, powered by a 350 small block. Nice chrome surround there, going all the way around the headlights and grill. Could use a good bath, that's for sure, but looks like a nice solid car. Again, got the Raleigh wheels on there. Newer top. Not too bad. Behind that, we've got this big old Lincoln riding on the wide whites there. This is actually, is it a 1970? Yeah, 1970 Lincoln with the hideaway headlamps. Pretty impressive grille there. The color's kind of cool. I bet it cleaned up pretty nicely. Of course, these Lincolns are big, comfortable luxury cars. All the power windows, locks, mirrors, probably even power seat on this one. Pretty impressive. And it says, actually it says this one has cold AC on it, so I guess everything's in good working order. Then next to that, we have this 1963 Ford Galaxy 500. And that's looking pretty mean in that black. It's got some Kragers on there. This is the 500XL. See the badging there. My son really likes the Galaxy 500 too, but this particular one has this flat back glass here. He actually likes the more fastback version. But it's still a pretty cool car. Very nice interior with little mid-height bucket seats, all in black vinyl. It is an automatic on the console. All original gauges and everything. Pretty cool. Just needs cleaned up. And I would assume we got a 390 under the hood here. Let's see if I can get this open for you. All right, they've kind of dressed it up a little bit, so it's not all original. It's got a chrome air cleaner, chrome valve covers. They've painted up the intake and everything. But it is an FE engine. You can tell that when you look at these, because if you look at right here where this intake, it actually comes up and meets the head here under the valve cover. So the valve cover actually overhangs the intake. That's an easy way to recognize an FE series engine. And that's exactly what this is. Next to that, we have this big old 1950s Buick. Got the portholes there. This should be a 54, sorry. Nice big chrome grille. And again, it has that sort of gun sight style hood ornament up top there. Pretty massive car. It's got a set of aftermarket wheels on there. Those are Boyd Coddingtons. Somebody paid some good money for those, I'm sure, at the time. And they said they actually added vintage AC to this one as well, so that's cool. Old hot rod back here. It's got the louvered hood, the lake pipes, dual spotlights. Hot rod peep style mirror there. Fender skirts. It's pretty cool. And behind that, we have this Buick Riviera. It's a pretty awesome car. You can see it's got that fastback styling. And 9,400 on that one. That's not too bad. That has a pretty aggressive look to it. Very nice. Big old Cadillac convertible here. With a really cool hood ornament. Very nice. That's a 69. And they say that's got nice cold AC in it as well. That's right next to a 1966 Ford Thunderbird. Pretty nice shape. It's got the correct Thunderbird caps on there and everything. It's got the Landau style top. And interior is always pretty cool on Thunderbirds. Pretty unique styling in there. It's got the mid-height bucket style seats. I like how the dashboard just kind of goes straight down into that console there. And then the gauges each have their own separate little pod. Definitely has a cool look to it. Even that speedometer is pretty unique. Let's see. Next to that looks like a Lincoln Premier, I believe. Big, massive Lincoln. Yeah, it's a 58 Lincoln Premier, it says. Now, that's a pretty awesome looking car. Sorry about the weird lighting here. But I mean, it almost looks like a custom with those crazy looking headlamps and everything. But that's exactly how they came from the factory. Nice little bits of trim. That's a pretty sweet car. That door feels like a bank vault door. Crazy. Power windows, power locks. Pretty wild looking steering wheel there. And unique set of gauges. I mean, it's kind of bizarre with that big flat panel there for the speedometer and everything. You can see the dashboard wraps all the way around to the pillar. Looks pretty untouched in there. That is actually a power seat as well. It's a bench seat, but it is powered. Still feels nice and solid. There's your Premier badges there. And it does have a little set of fins on there. It's definitely pretty cool. And this has a front hinged hood. So we'll flip that open for you. Put a massive V8 in there. Very cool. I will tell you one thing about the Lincoln Premiers is that the parts are pretty hard to come by when you go to restore them, but this one actually looks like it's in pretty great condition already, so not bad at all. Then right next to that we have a 1970 Chevrolet El Camino, and one of the best looking front ends ever put on a Chevy. Obviously, it's the same as the Chevelle SS from that year. Even has the SS trim there, the dual stripes, with the hood bulge and everything. It's got some rally wheels on there. Pretty nice looking El Camino. Looks like they sprayed in some sort of coating on the bed. Nice new upholstery on the seats there. And it's got a tiny little aftermarket wheel. That's kind of weird, but that could be changed easily enough. But other than that, nice looking car. Door panels look like new. All right, guys, we're probably about halfway through this shed, but I'm gonna go ahead and call this the end of this particular video. And I think this is long enough for one segment. But as always, we appreciate you watching and commenting and everything. And if you haven't already, please go ahead and subscribe to our channel, and we'll have many more of these videos in the future. Thanks again. Bye.